The Great Pyramid of Giza. The only wonder of the ancient world still standing due to simple, but yet brilliant design and perfect application during construction. How did they do it? Over the years, many theories have been presented to the public. All are under discussion, and some gather more facts and are considered to be more accurate. From this image found in a simple search, you could see a slight difference in the colors in some parts of the sides, as if there is a virtual vertical axis running from top to bottom. If you search some more, you will find that this is more observable during equinox. More images provide better view of the effect and reveal an eight-sided pyramid of some sort. Is this possible? Is this a fact? Questions have been raised about the subject. Many answers have been given. This video also provides an answer that will be explained better further on. For the time being, we only need to remember that the Great Pyramid has four sides. It is time to see some more images and techniques and designs. We move on to the next peculiar image. A survey in the 1980s recorded a possible internal ramp. On that survey was based the brilliant presentation of Mr. Jean-Pierre Houdin regarding the construction of the Great Pyramid. Since I also consider that an internal ramp was used, as Mr. Houdin explained, additional information will be provided in this video. Time to view some other pyramids. We can start from the stepped pyramid, created at the era of Djoser. We can see the distinctive layers or steps of the pyramid. We have seen similar design in other civilizations also. A 3D image of the pyramid, with the underground layer, is most revealing. It seems that Djoser was the starting point of a series of designs. Although no evidence of a ramp used is found, something similar mechanism should have been used in this construction also. Another stepped pyramid at Meidum, that is thought to be just the second pyramid built after Djoser's, and may have been originally built for Huni, the last pharaoh of the third dynasty, and continued by Sneferu. It seems that the design of the pyramids was perfected mostly by Sneferu. The next one is the bent pyramid. Having an initial angle of 54 degrees, it changes to 43 degrees later on. This was created during Sneferu era. It seems that they miscalculated the angle and ended up with this result. I think that Sneferu was the first one to insert the internal ramp in the design of the pyramids, but it is going to be a bit hard to prove. Perhaps what created it was the need to improve the design of Djoser's stepped pyramid. Next one is Sneferu's red pyramid. This, someone would think, was the finalization of the design. No, the angle used is 43 degrees. So it seems that Sneferu just wanted another pyramid, but used a safer angle, already proven correct from the Bet pyramid. Even later pyramids must have used the same technique and use an internal ramp. The pyramids of Sahur and Neferfra have such signs upon closer look. Those were built after the Great Pyramid of Giza, so this proves that the designs were kept and improved. We also need to have in mind some vital information regarding the material used. Wood came from Lebanon. A trip could take a long time if the ship returned. Stone that was used, limestone, granite, came from quarries that exist close or far away from the building site. A trip for stone blocks could equal a ship sailing the Nile. The building site is not near the palace of the era. We tend to create cemeteries not very far to where we reside, but in certain locations. The location is hand-picked, for a certain reason, surely known to ancient Egyptians. Ancient Egyptians were already knew how to build pyramids at the era of Khufu. So they simply were improving designs. But they also were improving logistics. Over the years, the need for material reuse became a necessity. Wood was reused in the construction of later pyramids. If a stone ramp was used, it was dismantled and reused in main construction. So a reuse logic was adopted on the resources used for construction. Ancient Egyptians had excellent geometry knowledge. They knew how to create symmetric structures and sculptures by using a combination of geometry shapes. If you take a closer look at this cross-section image of the Great Pyramid, in this Britannica article, you will notice quickly the positions of the air shafts. They have similar angles, it's certainly not by chance. The same angle should have the descending passageway, to my opinion, but it does not appear so in this image. One more thing worth mentioning is the vertical virtual axis that the three chambers appear to be symmetric to. Ancient Egyptians were reusing designs. Vertical shafts were not unknown to the architect of the Great Pyramid of Giza. No thanks to Djoser's pyramid. Perhaps a shaft exists in all pyramids, or it has been replaced by a vertical axis that creates a symmetry. But we also need to consider one more thing. Over the years, earthquakes might have happened. Some of the designs might have produced problems. Large construction weight is a problem. Does the subsoil geology provide proper foundation for the construction? Surely it is a factor to take upon consideration when earthquakes occur. Let us return to the internal ramp theory. We can search the 3D image created from Djoser stems for that purpose. We can view the alignment of the known corridors and shafts. Then we take a look once more at the cross-section of the pyramid, in an image indicating a large void that was found. To my opinion, more such voids should occur as we go up, but this is only a theory. Now let's measure the angle of the Grand Gallery. I found a simple web tool for this purpose that can export an image. You will find a link in the details of this video. The lovely part was that the angle appears to be 26 degrees, which is half of the almost 52 degrees angle of the pyramid. Everything was converted to geometry problems for ancient Egyptians during this construction. Another thing to notice is that the actual entrance of the pyramid, the north face corridor, appears to be at a close height with the pathway to the Queen's Chamber. Also, the mysterious void that was discovered is parallel to the same pathway, and surprisingly on the same height with the end of the air shaft from the Queen's Chamber. This makes me believe that this is not the only void in this pyramid. In this image, you will notice clearly the triangle created under the Grand Gallery. It would be very convenient that pathway to be the corner of a small pyramid having 26 degree angle. It is mentioned several times in this video that ancient Egyptians were reusing and improving designs. So are you prepared to see the 60 degree angle inner pyramid that was used in the design for the ramp? We will need a better image for that, and we have one. So let us take a closer look. Remember that an inner spiral should have been used. Also, the pyramid seems to have a vertical axis running in the middle of it. So perhaps a vertical shaft or something similar does exist hidden in the form of another relief chamber. The lower air shafts have almost the same angle, 39 degrees. The overall pyramid angle is a bit more than 51 degrees. In a triangle, the sum of all angles is equal to 180 degrees. The sum of 39, 51 and 90 is 180. The angle of the upper shafts is not a coincidence. Have this in mind, 32 degrees and 36 minutes, minus 26 degrees and 16 minutes equals 6 degrees and 20 minutes. On the other hand, 51 degrees and 50 minutes, minus 45 degrees, which is the angle of the left upper shaft, equals 6 degrees and 50 minutes. Definitely not a coincidence, nothing more but a very well thought geometry design. Now let's see the angle of the Grand Gallery. It is 26 degrees. The descending passageway has the same angle, by the way. There is a symmetry on the horizontal axis among those two pathways. As above, so below. The Queen's shaft has a 60 degree angle, if measured from the start of the Grand Gallery. It is easy now to distinguish, using bold lines, the area left for the internal spiral ramp. As we go up in height, the width of the corridor becomes more narrow. This is expected, as you usually put larger stones below and smaller on top in large stone structures. But we will see in this image that some layers had larger blocks, even if in larger height. You can see that a layer of larger blocks appear at 70 meters, just above the area where a large void has been found. It is time now to remember the question about the eight sides of the pyramid. They are not eight, but four. So how this straight vertical line appears not only to the Great Pyramid, but on others, if you look closely. They created a smaller pyramid first having angle 26 degrees, and rotated by 90 degrees south. The corner side of that pyramid is exactly in the middle of the side of the actual pyramid. For this purpose, I have created a simple 3D model for you to understand better. First of all, the underground work was done. Then a flat base was created. Now comes the inner smaller pyramid of 26 degrees angle. The corner of this structure will be the grand gallery corridor later on. The internal ramp needs a spine. For this purpose, a 60 degree inner pyramid is used in this design. The queen's shafts are windows in this inner pyramid and were covered by other limestone blocks as the construction grew higher. The internal ramp is revealed in this design. See how it embraces the 60-degree inner pyramid. This spiral ramp was actually sort of an external spiral ramp at the time of construction. Just remember the Meidum pyramid right now. You get the point. All that is left now is the final layer, the one that gives the pyramid its 51-degree and 50-minute angle. Project completed. But wait, would you think the casing stones were put from bottom to top, or vice versa? I think they started from the top, closing everything on the way down. If you view the locations of the pyramids, how they are scattered north and south of the Nile River bank. With so many sand hills there and so many ancient Egyptian pharaohs, I think we have not seen all pyramid designs and attempts out there. Based on all that information, I think that not only one void should be present in this pyramid. There must be more empty space towards the top of the pyramid. Khufu was clever. We may think that this tomb was raided, but what a better way to discourage potential grave diggers than to show that this tomb has already been opened. So I would expect a void between 80 and 90 meters, and a relief chamber, or a void above 90 meters height. Thank you for watching.